Hello everyone, my name is Lavina Chitara and my today's topic is wine quality analysis that comes under food and beverages section. First I'll introduce my team members who supported me for this analysis. The names are Abhijit Kaur, Akhil Nair and Kef Mazhar. Thank you guys. Let's start first by deciding the agenda. First is objective. This is the first and very important phase of the analysis, where we actually decide what you want in an output, what are the expectations, and what actually end user wants from you. In this phase, we need to clarify the requirements by asking related questions that gives better idea to select the right track of the analysis and help you to select which part of the section of the domain you need to focus on, which is really very important before starting any of the analysis. The second agenda is data description. In this phase, our journey will start by analyzing the data, their values, their types, defining the data by the filtration. The third agenda is data analysis. In this section, we actually play with lots of numbers, with lots of different visualization techniques to make it more user-friendly for users. The fourth and last one, which is insights from analysis. After every analysis, we conclude some points like negative or positive correlations between attributes, or you can say factors, and other observations like which factor depends on which other factor, like the way we'll see in the next slides. Objective. The first objective is to prepare our data as per our requirement, and in our case we need to classify the quality of the wine in specific categories like excellent, normal and poor. The second object is to create visualizations to show how residual sugar, density and alcohol affect the quality of the wine. Univariate and bivariate analysis. Univariate is nothing but analysis with only single variable in which we visualize the distribution of the data, whether it is normalized or not, or if it is not normalized, then we normalize it. Bivariate analysis, correlation between two variables that shows how one variable affects to the other factor. Just like that way, we do analysis with other factors also in terms of quality and decide how it can lead to faulty or poor quality of wine and how we can improve its quality by visualizing different correlations. The second agenda is data description. Here we can see there are lots of input variables and one output variable. Let's move to our code. Here I am loading my data from the source CSV file. I'm showing only top 5 rows. Here you can see there are 12 columns, including the quality, which is number. Here we need to add one more column as per the quality number. We need to classify them as a category. And you can calculate that statistics where you can find it out. Mean value, standard deviation, minimum and maximum values. That is a range of the column values. You can find it out quartiles, first quartile, second quartile and third quartile. Here you can see in the values of two columns, free sulfur dioxide and total sulfur dioxide, here range is a little bit higher. So you can see the other column values in between 0 to 15, whereas for these two column values, the range is little bit higher. So let's move to our slide. Okay, so this one is done. Yeah, statistics we have done. So now the third agenda, data analysis. We first start with the data preparation, where we clean the null values, we clean the null columns as well as, and as per our requirement, we create a one column named as a classification, where we have decided one range for the quality numbers. Like if it is more than 7, then we will assign it as excellent category. And if it is in between 7 to 5, we will assign as a normal. And if it is below 5, then we will assign as the wine is poor quality. Okay, so let's suppose I added one classification category, classification column, as per the quality number. You can see the 8 quality showing excellent quality, 6 is showing normal quality, and 4 is showing poor quality. Now, what we are saying over here, the volatile acidity, citric acid, chlorides, density, and alcohol, all these variables are playing major role in classifying wine quality. Let's prove it. Let first analysis the quality of wine with respect to density, alcohol, and residual sugar. If you look at the graph between alcohol versus quality, you can see the positive correlation it's showing. Like if you increase alcohol, it increases the quality of wine. But if you will see, the density has a negative correlation with the quality. If it is increasing, then quality will go down. But if you will see the third figure, residual sugar, there is a little bit confusion. Means like it is not clearly visualizing the data and we can't conclude. So let's normalize its data. So we just normalize the data by finding the log values of the column residual sugar, and here we can little bit clearly showing. Here you can see residual sugar level. You can see that it is showing little bit up for the excellent quality. Normal quality it's going down, and for the poor quality it's again going up. So it is not very clear. And we are not able to conclude anything like it's a positive correlation or negative correlation with the quality. So let's try by the another graph, which is scatter plot with the regression lines. So here we can clearly say that residual sugar has a negative correlation with the quality. So sugar ratio should be less to make the good quality of wine. See here, this whole thing is like to show the stages of the analysis, that how we did it by different graphs and try to conclude by the only clear visualization. Okay, now univariate analysis. Here you can see there are lots of graphs for the factors like fixed acidity, volatile acidity, citric acid, density, pH, sulfates, and alcohol. Majority of samples here you can see are average quality, with the few having high quality and few still having with a poor quality. Both distribution for fixed acidity and volatile acidity have long positive tails. This makes their mean higher than their medians and make median better measure of the central values. Also, both has a slight bimodal distribution. You can see in a red and green graph easily. Citric acid seems to be positively skewed and seems to have outliers too. So obviously, median would be better measure of central value. The unusual spike in the graph indicates that a few concentrations are higher than the others. The density, pH, and sulfate seems to have a normal distribution and little standard deviations, which means that the wines have almost similar values. If outliers wherever they appear could be removed, and their mean and median values are almost same. Alcohol distribution is slightly skewed. Its mean and median values are almost same, and all wines have some alcohol in them, and the minimum is 8%. So next, we again do a univariate analysis with the residual sugar, chlorides, free sulfur dioxide, and total sulfur dioxide. Here it is showing two figure. One is whatever the data set we have given, and the second one is the data we normalized, and after normalization we plotted the graph. So you can see the clearly you can conclude some points like residual sugar and chlorides are highly positively skewed. Free sulfur dioxide and total sulfur dioxide also positively skewed. and their outliers can be removed by taking up top 1% values, and that would be give us a better indication of their effect. And also free sulfur dioxide has a quite a spiky distribution, which perhaps might indicate that some levels are more common than others. Let's move to our bivariate analysis. Here, let's analyze the correlation between factors with respect to quality. First, take positively correlated factors with quality like citric acid, sulfate, and fixed acidity. Normal and excellent wines have a higher median citric acid amount compared with the poor wines. Above graph clearly shows wine quality improves with the increasing values of citric acid, sulfates, and fixed acidity. So you can see that it's citric acid, increasing values of citric acid increases the quality of wine. The same with the sulfates and fixed acidity. Now take a negative correlation with volatile acidity, pH, and chlorides. You can clearly observe that volatile acidity decreases the quality of a wine. Here you can observe large number of outliers in a chloride values in normal quality wine, and excellent wines are less salty as compared to others. Okay, so there are lots of different variable analysis we can do with the different factors. But now here I'm analyzing the dependencies between factors, that how one factor can affect to other. Let's try to find out the dependency between sulfates and free sulfur dioxide in terms of quality. Here we can say sulfates has a positive correlation with the quality. As amount of sulfates gets increased, then the quality of wine also get increased. But if you look at the figure 2, which is showing three variable correlation together, let's first look at the correlation between sulfates and free sulfur dioxide. Both also have positive correlation, but if we look at the relation between free sulfur dioxide and quality, free sulfur dioxide reduces the quality. So if you will increase the free sulfur dioxide, it reduces the quality. So we conclude that increasing the sulfate is good, but need to take care of free sulfur dioxide, as because of negative correlation of free sulfur dioxide with the quality. Now take one more analysis in between pH and fixed acidity in terms of quality, where we have proved in a previous slides in a bivariate analysis that fixed acidity has a positive correlation with the quality. So if you look at figure 1, we can say fixed acidity has negative correlation with the pH. So if you will increase fixed acidity, then pH level will get decreased, which is really very good for making good quality of wine. But if you will see figure 2 correlation of variable fixed acidity with the chlorides and chlorides with the quality, as we are saying, increasing values of a fixed acidity is good because it reduces the pH level. But if we relate fixed acidity with the chloride, it shows a positive correlation. As if fixed acidity increases, then chloride will also get increased. But this chloride affect to our quality. How? Because chloride increasing the chloride values decreases the quality. So this graph concludes that if we increases fixed acidity, then need to take care of chloride values also, as it has a negative correlation with the quality. So basically these two graphs clearly show dependency of the combinational factors to improve the quality of the wine. So at last, what we have proved the line which we have shown earlier in the slide, that volatile acidity, citric acid, chlorides, density, and alcohol playing major roles in classifying the quality of wine. Thank you all and enjoy good quality of wine. Cheers. Thank you.